Do you sometimes need to refund money to your prepaying clients? Well, then you need the proper technique on how to record refunds to clients. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Sometimes prepaying clients would like their balance refunded to them. There could be many reasons why they ask. The way you record this is simple and makes the trial balance and customer's balance correct. So what must we do? Well, we have to record a decrease in the cash in bank at the moment we pay the money back to the client. And of course, we have to remove the client's balance from the unearned legal fees account because we owe less to the client in future services because we paid them back their money today. And of course, we must also make the client's balance in the customer records become zero. So how do we do this? Well, first, we write a check to the client. The account in the expense field of the check is the unearned legal fees account. This will remove the customer's balance from the unearned legal fees account. Then we must apply the remaining overpayment to the check in order to clear the customer's balance. We do this in the receive payment window. Then we check to make sure that we have zero for the client in the open invoice report. For example, let's imagine on April 12th, we gave check number 6 to Betty Boop for $4,000 to cancel future services. Now, before we do any more or talk any more, let's look reports and let's look at the open invoice report. You see, right now we owe Betty $4,000 in future legal services because that's currently the difference between all the money she paid us and all the invoices that we billed her for. All those other details would be listed on the transaction list by customer report, but we're mostly concerned with wiping out this balance and having it become zero. The trial balance will change and cash in bank will decrease by $4,000 from what it is now, and it will become $18,305. And unearned legal fees become so low, it actually becomes a positive number. It becomes positive 300. And we will first write the check, then we will apply it to the remaining past payment to remove all Betty's transactions from the open invoice report. So watch how we write the check. We click New, and we go over to Check. Now the date we know is April 12th of 2021. And the customer to whom we're writing the check to is Betty Boop. And we have to make sure that we're paying from the correct bank account. And we're probably up to check number 6. I didn't give a check number. Yeah, check number 6. There we are. Now watch this. The category, the account that would normally be an expense, is the unearned legal fees account. Unearned legal fees. That's the account that's decreasing. Make sure you also choose Betty. It is not billable because it's not really an expense we're paying. And the amount is $4,000. So this is the way you write the check to remove a client's balance if you're giving them back money. In the bottom right, you click Save and Close. And now you notice both the check and the remaining amount of the other payment zero each other out and become zero. Now, the open invoice report should show nothing under Betty instead of a negative and a positive. So we'll go back and we'll put these, apply these two together in a moment. But first, let's click Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see cash in bank is now $18,305. It has decreased by the $4,000 we paid. And unearned legal fees has become a positive $300. And that's because it's equal to a positive number. Reports, open invoice. Notice, Alan still has a negative balance because he's prepaid. But Candy, who owes us money, who we did the service for, owes us $300 more than we owe Alan. That's why the net result is $300 positive. So the results are correct. And we're almost finished. The proper bookkeeping form says even though Betty's balance says zero, we can't leave it like this. We have to apply these two items together in the Receive Payment window. We click New, and we go down to Receive Payment. Now, actually, we don't do that. I'm sorry. We double-click and open up the existing payment. Sorry about that. We double-click and open the existing payment, and you can see that for some reason the check has been added to this payment. It really hasn't been added. When you open any prior payment, if there are new invoices or checks, they'll be listed here. But you see, it's not been applied to this payment. This payment was $8,000, and in the past, we only applied this invoice for $4,000. So this check for $4,000, if we click the check mark, now, wait, well, let's remove it. You see how it goes down here? This is the way it looked before we added the check. Now, all we have to do is click the check mark, and it will be added to this past payment that was made back on January 2nd. Look in the bottom right when we click the check mark. The amount extra disappears because this check and this invoice will both be applied to the January 2nd payment. Now when we click Save and Close and we click Yes, look at the open invoice. Betty is completely gone, and that's the way the numbers should look.